Guys, you're probably wondering why I'm trying to talk to you in this wind tunnel, in this extreme cold. It's because we're trying to bring to you a special project right now.
Hey, Steven, what do you say we turn up the snow just a little bit more?
We're trying to get under the skin of what makes Mercedes-Benz Mercedes-Benz. Right now, we're in the most extreme conditions. Guys, are you serious? Come on!
Right now, we're in the engine room of one of the world's first weather tunnels, or what they call it at Mercedes-Benz, the weather god.
This is not what you expected to see, right? Us neither. Today, we want to find out what makes a Mercedes-Benz so comfortable in all weather conditions.
So right now, we're in the engine room of one of the world's first weather tunnels, or what they call it at Mercedes-Benz, the weather god. Facilities like this one are used to simulate all kinds of weather conditions, including wind and rain.
Hello.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
It is so cold.
Hi there, I'm Elly.
Hi, Elly.
So, what are we doing here? What is this?
This is the Mercedes-Benz cold test tunnel. And we are doing our winter tests here to prepare the vehicles for outside tests.
Is this like all weathers or just particularly cold in this one?
We can just simulate rain. We can simulate snow here. We have a second tunnel here where we can simulate high temperatures and sun intensities.
So speaking of all kinds of weather, what is the temperature right now in this room?
As you can see on the board over there, we have minus 10 degrees. Little comfortable, because we're going to use it at minus 20 degrees to get the best for the customer at the end.
And getting the best for the customer, so you go to extreme weather conditions and you're testing it here. And what is the purpose for that? Like, what is the outcome?
We have customers all around the world. So we have customers in the middle of Europe, south of Europe, where it's very warm, but we have also customers in the north countries. So for example, Scandinavian countries, Sweden, Finland, or back in the United States, Alaska, We have to prepare vehicles for them.
So you could literally make your own snow, but it's not like real snow. It's like almost drier, you know?
If we would use wet snow, like you have in winter time, everything would just be glued with the snow and would be very wet here. And then it would not be possible to have good test conditions.
What's the lowest temperature you can get this down to? Because I can feel the wind coming from the wind tunnel right now. So wind chill plus minus temperatures. Like, what's the coldest?
The coldest from feeling, I think minus 60 degrees.
Oh. Yeah,
because of the wind chill effect.
This car behind you is completely frozen over. Is this for a particular test or has it just been in here a while?
Yeah, this is our EQS. It's fully iced, as you can see. This vehicle is just prepared for a heat up. If you like to, we can start it from here using the Mercedes-Benz app.
Oh.
And it's just preconditioning. I can start it for you if you like to. Okay. This will start. If you like to, we can go into the control room and check from there how this heat up will work.
Is it warmer in there?
Yeah, it's much warmer there.
Okay, let's go.
So guys, that's the result. 20 minutes of heating up the vehicle as we saw it before. We had this ice on the surface and now the windows are just de-iced. The front shield is de-iced. As you can see, you can just move the rest of the snow this was on the vehicle. And I think if we would be on the road, we are good to go.
How about we get inside and turn on those heated seats?
I have a better idea. We can just switch to the next stage if you like to.
So there's heat involved?
Yeah, really.
Oliver, let's go.
Okay, let's go.
Now that looks a lot better.
Ooh, definitely.
Do you want to take a look?
Let's go.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. Okay, we got it. Thank you.
Hey, ladies, break is over.
Oh, sorry.
I see you find our heat tunnel, right?
Yeah, I mean, this place is crazy. It's so hot in here.
Yeah, this is because you put on the sun. Maybe we should switch it off or move it to another position.
You can move it?
Yeah, sure, I'll show you.
Have you seen this before?
No.
Okay, kannst du fahren? Nach links, bitte. So we just been able to move the sun from the top side with the 90 degrees sun angle to this 45 sun degrees angle to have in the measurement that is the sun comes from the side and from the top.
Are you testing the performance of the car in the heat or the actual internal AC, sort of how the controls all work?
Yeah, we're just testing that. We want to ensure that the customer always gets the perfect climatization inside his cabin. And so we have to do some performance tests that we are doing here in the wind tunnel and the other tests on the road. But for the road tests, we have to prepare the vehicles here. We have to check them first if the AC circuit is just sufficient for driving on the roads and for driving on different roads, for example, in Dubai or in the south of the United States, as well as in Europe.
So this is not only just heat like the sun, it's actually got UV as well.
Yeah, that's true. This is why you get the sunscreen before you just ended here. It's a real sun here.
Yeah, and you can actually get a tan in here.
Yeah, for sure, but...
I feel my ears kind of getting a little red. This also has wind capabilities
right?
So why would you need the wind as well?
To get as near as to the road as possible. This is what we need the wind for, that's what we need the sun for.
I think it's time to test out the AC because it is getting a little warm in here. That's much nicer.
But it's still hot. Would you like to switch on the AC, please?
Yeah.
We can use the preconditioning feature if you like to. And now you recognize the system was started. We're switching to the cooling mode. That's why we are showing this blue line over there.
Are you just trying to make sure it's as easy for the customer to get the car to cool down as you can?
Yeah, that's the main purpose. That the customer just sits into his vehicle, starts the vehicle, or just starting preconditioning, and then it's going to be cooled down. If you like to program the pre-entry climate control, you can just go into this menu, set up a new departure time, for example. Mm-hmm. You can set up here. And here you can choose the seats for seat venting and seat heating that will be activated as well when you're just entering the vehicle.
And what's the perfect cabin temperature?
Our expectation is that the customer can set it to 22 degrees or 72 degrees Fahrenheit. Yeah, that's our perspective for the best comfort in the vehicle. We want to feel how the customer feels. That's our goal. We see it with the customer's eyes and that's why we are going inside.
This is so cool. What do you guys do here?
We are investigating a topic all drivers experience when it's raining, then the water is propagating along the vehicle and we take care that the driver still can have a good visibility and of course ensure safety, comfort.
Like looking at this facility, like how long has this been here for? I feel like this has been part of Mercedes-Benz for quite a while.
Yes, it is a historic site here. The building took place at the 30s and then some pure aerodynamic drag investigations have been done. 70s, it started that we want to work for this water management topic.
I'm just honestly still geeking out about the room that we're in. Can you explain all the moving components that we're standing around?
Yes, of course. Actually, let's start from the beginning. So this is the wind tunnel nozzle. The wind is coming from here. You see the words here, the storm starts here. And then we have here some spray nozzles, seven, and they inject a lot of very tiny small droplets. And they hit the vehicle. And the good thing is we are not working with pure water. It is also having a very tiny amount of fluorescence dye. And we have then UV lights and with all of them, we can make the water visible.
These climate wind tunnels at Mercedes-Benz can simulate any kind of climate condition across the world at a push of a button, from scorching heat to freezing cold. But how exactly does it work? Let's take a closer look.
So what you see here is a model of a Göttingen-type wind tunnel. This means that the airflow that is created by this big fan is recirculating in the tunnel that is built like a closed circuit. And what you see in the corner of the wind tunnel are guiding vanes. They guide the air in the most efficient way possible around the corners before it's led through the flow straightener and dampening screens. Then through the wind nozzle, where it's accelerated to the respective air velocity. Along the way, the airflow temperature is controlled by a cooling system that sits right here. And now back to Germany.
I'm like excited to see what happens now.
The majority of the water is impacting on the windscreen. And for that, we have the wiper. But the wiper is also pushing most of the water to the A-pillar. Imagine when there's nothing to guide the water upwards, then we would have a lot of water over the A-pillar. And this helps us to bring the water to the roof and get rid of it.
I can see where you were talking about the A-pillar, because I can see where the rain comes up the top of the car and it starts to pull off there.
So we have also a different view for that. Maybe that's also helpful when we look from top. You see how the wipers are behaving. There's this viewing zone here, which is the most crucial one, where the driver looks to the mirror glass and where it's the view cone is intersecting with the side window.
As we're looking at it in the lighting, there's no fluorescent drops there basically at all.
That's awesome.
It makes a lot of sense now seeing that they do this. Things like we take for granted.
Yeah. How close can we get to 250 just to see it?
I think we could.
Can we turn it up to hurricane?
Hurricane?
Yeah.
No.
Please?
Yeah. Yes. Cool. Let's go.
Faster wind means also the free stream droplets here. They are more following the streamline. The water in contact with the surface, of course, is also following the aerodynamic streamlines.
That's wild. So today, at the start of our journey, we found out what makes a Mercedes-Benz so comfortable, no matter what the weather conditions are outside, even conditions that we've never even witnessed. Well, we have now. And best believe, if we found ourselves in that situation, we want to be sat in a Mercedes-Benz, as it creates a cocoon of comfort around the driver, no matter what's happening outside.
This is it for our adventure in the fascinating climate tunnels. But there's a lot more for us to discover at Mercedes-Benz. Check out our other episodes for more amazing stories and insights.